If you're an Arch Linux user, even if you generally avoid the AUR, there is a very high likelihood you've used it at least a couple of times. And recently you may have seen this video about malware discovered on the AUR. These packages have since been removed, but this was not the first case, and will not be the last case of malware on the AUR. And turns out, you didn't have to wait that long, because new packages have been made. Chrome and Chrome-bin, obviously targeting Google Chrome users. Now there is a real Chrome package on the AUR, Google-Chrome. This package, totally fine, keep using it. But Chrome and Chrome-bin, those are malicious. Now, these have also since been removed. Here is deletion request for Chrome, and here is Chrome-bin. Both have been accepted. There was also another case called GDOX. Now, I've never heard of a GDOX application, and this one wasn't malware, it was just deleting some directories, so it's more likely that the packaging was just a little bit broken, but this has also been since removed. But that got me thinking. If you have an AUR account on every single AUR package, there is going to be a submit request button. Under here, we can set the type, deletion, merge, or orphan, and then include a comment about what we're trying to do here. This isn't dealt with by the individual package maintainer. It can be, but if they're not responding, if nobody is there to look at it, this is dealt with by the overall AUR maintainers, the people that maintain the repo. Deletion is for removing the package, merge is for merging it with another one, and then orphan if the maintainer cannot be contacted and maybe you want to go and take over the package. Now, with this being the case, you might have some perception of how much this system is used, how many requests the AUR maintainers get. I don't think you have any idea how much work these people do, how many requests come in every single day. So this right here is the list of every single thread. This isn't converted into my local time zone, so this is saying August 4th. Let's go back a couple of pages. Each page has 10 results. Let's go page 4. Still August 4th. Let's go page 6. Okay, so somewhere between those two points. So there's about 4.5 pages, so about 45 requests just on that single day. And the day before was more. That had about 70 requests. Now, of course, some days are way less busy, others even more so. There are some days that have over 100 requests to deal with. This is a constant stream of people wanting to make very little changes to the AUR. Now, most of these cases are not malware. The AUR is not full of malware where things need to be deleted every single day. The majority are deletion requests, but for pretty mundane reasons, and I'm going to show you some of those reasons. MediaWiki extension check user. This is now part of MediaWiki, so there's not really any reason to have a separate package to add the feature when the feature is in the thing to add the feature to. So that one got accepted. One interesting thing is you as the user are not actually able to delete your packages. So if you do something like you break the package and you'll deal with it later, because you can't have broken packages on the AUR, you can just ask them to just delete it and then you'll come back to it later, and that's totally fine as well. In a similar vein, here is 42fetch-git. I tried to make a package to see how it works. I'll make a better one when I'll have time. For now, it's so bad, it's preferable to delete it. So this is somebody who was working on a package. They didn't really know what they were doing. It's probably their first package. And, you know, they don't have time to deal with it now. So just get rid of it. And that's a problem for another time. Now, here's one that hasn't been dealt with. Orphan package, not useful without a maintainer to update because upstream does not have stable releases. Unclear whether failure to build noted in last comment was resolved. Appears to have been previously uploaded by a bot. Low slash no usage, zero package stats. So it's a package that nobody is using. It was being maintained by a bot account previously. The bot seems to be down or removed or something's happened to it. So there's nobody maintaining it. and nobody upstream is building stable releases, so there's nothing to actually pin this package to. So probably is going to get deleted, but as of right now, unclear. Now, sometimes there are packages that have no reason to exist. This is axiom-git. Packages must be useful. This is one of the rules of the AUR. This one says non-functional, do not install, and deprecated. That actually was in the description. Of course, this one has been accepted. Why would you upload a broken package? There's no reason for it to be here. Nobody can use it. Now, sometimes requests are made and they're probably not going to be dealt with. Upstream archive code since 2022. I don't know why that... Did you put a space in there? Okay, but archived code is not necessarily a reason to remove a package. There are tons of projects on the AUR where they haven't been updated in years. Take all of the tiny random little window managers from the 90s that still work on X11, but nobody's touched the code base in a very long time. And a prime example that a lot of people still use is a little project called NeoFetch. This hasn't been updated in, well, 4-5 years. People still use this because the project's still working. Now, a lot of people have migrated over to various other tools and things like that, but NeoFetch is still actually packaged in most distros. Now, some are rejected because they don't really know what they're requesting. This is for Linux-versioned-bin. Arch Linux Archive should not be repacked. So Arch Linux has this problem where they don't version number the kernel files, so you can only have one kernel version installed unless you have like an LTS and a Xen and things like that. But if you have like stable, you can only have one stable kernel installed at a time because they don't include the version number in the name. Including the version number is what most distros out there do, and that's basically what this package does as well. This package has a reason for existing. It's not just repacking the Arch archives just for no reason. It is trying to solve a problem that some users have. So of course, this one ultimately did get rejected because it has a clear use case. It has a reason for existing. Now, some are rejected for kind of dumb reasons. Package unnecessarily downloads 1.1 gigabyte of Godot templates in prepare function, discarding all but 70 megabyte. Maintainer was made aware of the issue late 2023, mid-2024, and early 2025. Workarounds were suggested by different users, but Maintainer did not respond, either to implement them or explain why they're unsuitable. Package should be disowned so someone else can update. This isn't a deletion request. This is an orphan request, okay? Keep that very clearly in your head. Here's the reply. Not a valid reason for deletion. Orphan request. No one's suggesting it be deleted. You are dealing with people here. People make mistakes. Clearly the maintainer is not actively maintaining the package, and the package should probably be handed over to another person so that they can fix the package if they want to. Now, most requests are doing things the correct way. Others, I don't think the user knows what a request is for. Orphan request for alien package converter. Please add inetutils or get text hostname as a requirement. The requests are not for poor requests. You're not making a change to the package. If you want to make a change to the package, contact the maintainer or be willing to take it over. Now, here's a really fun and a really dumb one. Cinnamon desktop-git. This is an orphan request for that package. It was flagged out of date a bit over a year ago. Are you going to adopt and update the cinnamon-git package builds? So right now, this package does exist on the AUR, but there's no maintainer. So the package is still out of date. The package still doesn't work. But now just no one's listed there instead of somebody who wasn't maintaining it. Now, sometimes you have a problem of a simple duplicated package. Deletion request for xlibre-x server. Duplicate of xlibre-server wish was submitted first. However, so there is also a request on the other side. Deletion request for xlibre-server. Xlibre file deletion request for xlibre-server. Hello, maintainer person. Thank you for your Xlibre packages. Currently, we from the official Xlibre team are adding our supported package build and related files to the AUR. So can you please remove all of the Xlibre related packages? Thank you, artist for Xlibre. So right now there is a deletion request for both Xlibre-X server and Xlibre-server. And then if we go to the comments on the Xlibre-X server package, the package maintainers are basically arguing with each other over who is maintaining it correctly, who has the correct Xlibre package, who should go forward being the maintainer. It is a hilarious mess, and I highly recommend you go and give it a read. Now, the AUR does not allow for duplicated packages, so there's a good chance that one of these is going to be removed, and at least going by AUR rules, it's probably going to be the newer one, Xlibre-X server. Now, sometimes the request comes directly from the upstream application developer. I am the owner, and I'd like to have this removed. It may be uploaded again at a much later date when it's more stabilized and usable. I simply don't want users testing this out without being prepared. People using without checking the GitHub source first, which has happened a lot. So there's nothing about the project stopping it being packaged on the AUR. There's not like a problem with it being packaged, but it's just very, very early, and the dev wants to actually get it ready before packages are made available. The AUR doesn't have to do this, but out of respect for the maintainer, that was accepted. Do you remember a couple of years back when DistroTube had a bunch of packages on the AUR for his builds of various suckless applications? Things like ST and DWM and DWM blocks and things like that. Now, initially, these were fine. These were promoted on his channel, people were downloading them, people liked the packages. In fact, other requests were made on the packages to merge ones together that didn't need to be duplicated. But then, I guess kinda out of nowhere, on every single one of his packages, deletion requests were made, specifically tailored for one person, and then all of these got accepted. Just out of nowhere, the packages were deleted. There was never an explanation on why they were fine before, but then suddenly weren't fine, why no one dealt with them when everybody knew they existed. But sometimes this happens as well. If a package actually is tailored for a single person, you can't use the AUR as a place to hold your build scripts. They have to be something that has value to other people. And I would argue at the time that these did have value to other people. Other people were installing them, but the maintainers at the time didn't agree. On that note, there are interesting cases like this one. Deletion request for hide-ext. A package build for someone's personal dot files does not really meet the usefulness criteria of the AUR. And the maintainer of this package got very, very annoyed with this because they felt like the person submitting this request didn't even read what the package was, didn't look at what it did, and was just trying to remove it for literally no reason. Because that's not what this project was. That's not even remotely what it was. What it actually was is basically plugins and then configurations for those plugins for an environment that exists on the AUR. It's not the same thing as that package. It wasn't a private configuration for that environment. It was something that extended that environment. There were some things that should be adjusted. It should be using the dash bin suffix and things like that, but those are legitimate changes to be had. It not existing on the AUR just didn't make any sense for what the package actually was. Now, of course, I have to show you a big one that happened recently. The request from the DuckStation maintainer. Basically, the maintainer of DuckStation really doesn't like the fact that packages exist that aren't just taking the app image and then installing it onto your system. And they actually took issue with two separate packages, one of those being DuckStation-Git, the other being the main DuckStation package. The DuckStation-Git one, they had issues because every so often it has issues building because it's a Git package, and that's what happens with Git packages. With the DuckStation one, didn't like the fact that it was being pinned to the last GPL commit before the license change was done, and which is totally fine under the license, and really didn't like that anyone was doing that. As it currently stands, this has not got any replies on it. Nothing has been done with the DuckStation package. It still exists on the AUR, and we'll see how that goes. Considering there's a chance Stenzek literally just drops Linux support, that'll be a good enough reason. Actually, no, maybe not. If you just pin it to the latest version and then just say this is the latest supported version, DuckStation already works pretty well. So, honestly, it may still exist on the AUR even after that. Now, the point of everything I've said here is there is a lot going on behind the scenes to keep the AUR running. There are not that many people dealing with it, but there is a lot of requests being made, a lot of things that need to be handled, and honestly, sometimes these reports just take a while to deal with sometimes. Some of these, they can sit there for a week or so because in a lot of cases, they might not really be that important, right? Like, there's not really a reason to address all of the kind of like, hey, I don't really want to deal with this package anymore, I'll deal with it later sort of things. Like, those can be dealt with later, unless you just happen to see it and just get rid of it straight away. But sometimes you get these ones where they do require a bit more thought. Does this belong in the AUR? Does this actually have a use? I need to have like a bit of back and forth, and then you need to actually like wait for someone to reply. And, you know, some of these legitimately do take a bit of time to deal with. And honestly, projects like this could absolutely benefit from having more people involved. So if you're an Arch user and you want to make your way into doing that, check out the Arch Wiki. There is a whole section on how to become a member of Arch and do all of that sort of stuff. And honestly, the best place to start is just get a package on the AUR. Learn how the AUR works, learn what you can do with it, and start working on packages that you notice might be a little bit less packaged than they should be. So, I don't know why I made this. I guess I just wanted to show what's going on the AUR. Let me know your thoughts down below. Have you ever maintained a package on the AUR? Have you ever submitted a request for something because you realized something's wrong with it? I'd love to know. Go subscribe to the channel, and if you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribesily Beripay, linked in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and you are a package. Yeah, that's what we're gonna I don't know what this ending is. What is this?